Snoop Dogg recently announced that he was going smokeless. Gasp! The King of MJ, not to be confused with the King of Pop, MJ, announced that he was cutting out what appears to be a major cornerstone of his brand, ganja. Can I say that on YouTube? Anyway, it wasn't about the ganja. Spoilers, it was an ad. Yeah, turns out it was an ad for like a smokeless stove or something. Or maybe it's a fire pit. I don't know. I stopped reading the article once I realized it was a commercial. And it was genius. It got everybody talking about it. And you know why? Look. I have a master's in business administration. That means that I'm smarter than you and I can pay off all of my student loans on a regular basis. And I have to say, based on my expertise, it's about the brand. It's about the expectations. That's the good thing about having a brand. You can set expectations for people. In this case, they fully expect at all times that Snoop Dogg will be high. That is a cornerstone of what we would call his brand. And then you can just with people. Once you have such an established brand and you've set such established expectations, you can play with it. You can play with the comedy of it. You can play with the horror of it. Really good recent example, Lizzo setting up the expectation in a cornerstone of her brand of being body positive. And so when all of those allegations came out about her not being that, it created shockwaves throughout the entire world. Somebody in a tiny town that only ranches, I don't know, turkeys because it's almost Thanksgiving. They're like, who's Lizzo? I don't care about that. Body positivity? What the f***? I'm positive. I'm going to rock your body. What? So that's the genius of brand, and that's why you should focus on yours. Also, this reminds me, I have like a personal Snoop Dogg story. I didn't get to meet him because I was just a lowly admin, but I used to work for Columbia Records. That's right. I'm a big deal. I used to process invoices for big A-listers like Beyonce. We were doing a music video for Big Time Rush, which was this like huge boy band right before One Direction. And then we signed One Direction and then we never spent any more attention or money on them. Back when we were spending attention and money on Big Time Rush, they had a music video that featured Snoop Dogg. Don't know why. This was for children. Maybe this was part of like the whole Martha Stewart rehabilitating her image thing with him. And so he was like safe for the kiddies, whatever. I mean, he seems like a really nice guy. He is like safe for the kiddies. It was just, it's like a surprising personality to put on a Disney channel or like an, was it Nickelodeon? I don't remember. So I would like book travel, process paperwork. Yep, that was pretty much it. And that took me like 12 hours a day. It sucked. I mean, I enjoyed working there. The job itself was like mind numbing. And I am not good at it. Anyway, so we had to hire somebody to like handle all of the writer. So like a writer, if you're not familiar, is like the list of things that you need for like the back room, like for the green room. And so we had to hire somebody to like go and like buy all the things. And Snoop Dogg had a very specific writer. And I ended up hiring one of my really good friend's roommates because he was like in between gigs or something. And I remember that like once he had gotten the job, and I know this because my friend was his roommate, he was stoked, obviously, because it's like Snoop Dogg. But then he was also worried because like we know how much he smokes. One of the things that my boss had told me that I had to tell him was like he might end up having to roll blunts for the guy. And so this poor guy was like up late at night practicing his role. Now, like in hindsight, I'm like, of course nobody else is rolling for Snoop Dogg. He probably does it himself, or like somebody from his entourage does, because they can probably do it way better than we can, because nobody smokes as much as Snoop Dogg. And that's why this was news. All of that to say, it's important to make your brand clear so that you can set up expectations and then mess with them. And that's what marketing is. Also, side note, like, weed is kind of bad for you. Like, don't get me wrong. I love it. And that's the problem, because I love it to the exclusion of everything else. And that's why I had to stop smoking. And it was really freaking hard to do. But coming up on a year sober in December, super proud of that. And you know what? The way that I had to get rid of it was I went on a road trip and then I threw it out the morning I was driving out so that I couldn't go back to the trash can and dig it out again. Yeah, that's where we were at. Okay, that's where we're at. Don't let anybody tell you that weed addiction is like not a thing. That was the thing, like nobody was really taking it seriously. I'd be like, oh, I'm like really concerned about how much I smoke. Like I literally can't go a single day without smoking it. Some of my friends were like, okay, but it's like just weed though. Like, that's not a big deal. You could do that. No, it's still a problem. Okay. Like, if you're one of those people who can just do it, like, a little bit here and there, like, maybe just at parties or whatever, more power to you. Go for it. But if you're like me and you literally can't go a day without smoking it, if it's in your house, that's a problem, baby. And you know what? I didn't like the person that I was on. Well, no, that's actually not true. I loved the person I was on when I was smoking weed. Like, there was nothing I loved more than just, like, going off into my own little world and just, like, dreaming. But you know what I realized? And this was one of the things that helped me make a change, was that I had all these dreams and I loved sitting there dreaming about them. But the more that you're just high all the time, the more that they're just dreams. And as the great Shia LaBeouf once said,
don't let your dreams be dreams.
You need to live them, babe.
Make your dreams come true. Just do it.
And so it had to go. And it's a struggle every single day, which is so fun. And my heart goes out to you if you are struggling in the same way. But just know, you can do it, baby. All right? I'm looking right at you. All right? This is eye contact. You can do it, babe. Now, where was I? Oh, yeah. That was pretty much it. Shout out to the subreddit r/leaves, by the way, if you are struggling with weed addiction. It's actually, like, it's unbelievable that I'm coming up on a year. That's crazy. Wow. And look how much I've done. For example, never would have been able to complete the music video for my song Dance with the Dead, which you should go watch right now, if I was still high. So go watch that. Anyway, love you. Bye.